Welcome back to our lectures on stylistics. This lecture has been designed at the Department of English and German Languages for students studying at the specialty Foreign Language to Foreign Languages. The theme of this lecture is Expressive Means and Stylistic Devices. The outline of the lecture covers the following points. First of all, we'll consider the notion of stylistic devices and expressive means. Then we'll talk about various types of expressive means. And then we'll speak about difference between stylistic devices and expressive means. Stylistics, sometimes called linguist stylistics, is a branch of general linguistics which deals mainly with the following interdependent tasks: the investigation of the inventory of special language media, which secure the desirable effect of the utterance, and certain types of text, discourse, which due to the choice and arrangement of language means, are distinguished by the pragmatic aspect of the communication. The two objectives of stylistics are clearly discernible as two separate fields of investigation. The types of texts that are distinguished by the pragmatic aspect of the communication are called functional styles of language, which we have considered in the previous lecture. And the special media of language, which secure the desirable effect of the utterance, are called stylistic devices and expressive means. In linguistics, there are different terms to denote particular means by which utterances are foregrounded, that is, made more conspicuous, more effective, and therefore imparting some additional information. They are called expressive means, stylistic devices, tropes, figures of speech, and other names. All these terms are used indiscriminately. We use figures of speech in figurative language to add color and interest, and to awaken the imagination. Figurative language is everywhere, from classical works like Shakespeare or the Bible, to everyday speech and television commercials. It makes the reader or listener use their imagination and understand much more than the plain words. Figurative language is the opposite of literal language. Literal language means exactly what it says. Figurative language means something different to, and usually more than, what it says on the surface. For instance, he ran fast. This is the example of the literal language. But he ran like the wind. This is the figurative language. Well-known Soviet linguist Galperin defines expressive means and stylistic devices as follows. The expressive means of a language are those phonetic means, morphological forms, means of word building, and lexical, phraseological, and syntactical forms, which exist in a language as a system for the purpose of logical and emotional intensification of the utterance. These intensifying forms of the language have been fixed in grammars and dictionaries. Some of them are normalized, and good dictionaries label them as intensifiers with the purpose of address to a living being or a thing for the sake of emphasis. In most cases, they have corresponding neutral synonymous forms. For example, he shall do it, which means I shall make him do it. Or, isn't she cute? Which means she's very nice, isn't she? Stylistics studies the expressive means of language, but from a special angle. It takes into account the modifications of meanings which various expressive means undergo when they are used in different functional styles. Expressive means have a kind of radiating effect. They noticeably color the whole of the utterance, no matter whether they are logical or emotional. Stylistic device is defined as a conscious and intentional intensification of some typical structural and or semantic property of a language unit, neutral or expressive, promoted to a generalized status and thus becoming a generative model. A stylistic device is an abstract pattern, a mold into which any content can be poured. The typical is not only that which is in frequent use, but also which reveals the essence of a phenomenon with the greatest and most evident force. Stylistic devices function in text as marked units. They always carry some kind of additional information, either emotive or logical. That is why the method of free variation employed in descriptive linguistics cannot be used in stylistics, because any substitution may cause damage to the semantic and aesthetic aspect of the utterance. Next, we will discuss types of expressive means, and the first is phonetic expressive means. As a general direction of the studies connected with stylistic devices shows, the most powerful expressive means of any language are phonetic. Pitch, melody, stress, pausation, drawling out certain syllables, whispering, a sing-song manner of speech, and other ways of using the voice are more effective than any other means in intensifying the utterance emotionally or logically. Morphological expressive means are of great importance. In parts of speech must be noted stylistic value of morphological irregularities. Passing over to some preliminary remarks on the morphological expressive means of the English language, we must point to what is now a rather impoverished set of media to which the quality of expressiveness can be attributed. However, there are some which, alongside their ordinary grammatical function, display a kind of emphasis and thereby are promoted to expressive means. These are, for example, the historical present, the use of shall in the second and third person, the use of some demonstrative pronouns with an emphatic meaning as those and them. Among the word-building means, we find a great many forms which serve to make the utterance more expressive by intensifying some of their semantic and or grammatical properties. The diminutive suffixes y-i-e let, for example, deary, sunny, auntie, streamlit, add some emotional coloring to the words. We may also refer to what are called neologisms and nonce words formed with non-productive suffixes or with Greek roots. Certain affixes have gained such a power of expressiveness that they begin functioning as separate words, absorbing all of the generalizing meaning they attach to different roots. Lexical expressive means and stylistic devices. Words in a context may acquire additional lexical meanings not fixed in the dictionaries, what are called contextual meanings. The latter may sometimes deviate from the dictionary meaning to such a degree that the new meaning even becomes the opposite of the primary meaning. What is known in linguistics as transferred meaning is practically the interrelation between two types of lexical meaning, dictionary and contextual. Lexical stylistic device is such type of denoting phenomena that serves to create additional expressive, evaluative, subjective connotations. In fact, we deal with the intended substitution results in a stylistic device, called also a trope. Lexical expressive meanings in which a word or word combination is used figuratively are called tropes. The majority of linguists agree that a word is the smallest unit being able to create images, because it conveys the artistic reality and image. On this level, the creation of images is the result of the interaction of two meanings, direct denotation and indirect figurative. At the syntactical level, there are many constructions which, when set against synonymous neutral ones, will reveal a certain degree of logical and emotional emphasis. And one more thing we have to discuss within this lecture is the difference between stylistic devices and expressive means. Stylistic devices and expressive means touch upon such general language problems as the aesthetic function of language, synonymous ways of rendering one and the same idea, emotional coloring in language, the individual manner of an author in making use of language, and a number of other issues. The difference between stylistic devices and expressive means is not large. They are closely connected with each other. The division of things into expressive means and stylistic devices is purely conventional, with the borders between them being somewhat shaky. Stylistic devices have a very strong effect. They can be logical and emotional, and they noticeably color the text. They reproduce the author's thoughts and feelings and make the reader think and feel what the author wants them to think and feel. The interrelation between expressive means and stylistic devices can be worded in terms of the theory of information. Expressive means have a greater degree of predictability than stylistic devices. The latter may appear in an environment which may seem alien and therefore be only slightly or not at all predictable. Expressive means, on the contrary, follow the natural course of thought, intensifying it by means of commonly used in language. It follows that stylistic devices carry a greater amount of information and therefore require a certain effort to decode their meaning and purport. Stylistic devices must be regarded as a special code which has to be well known to the reader in order to be deciphered easily. This is all in brief concerning the theme of this lecture. And these are the comprehension questions which you are giving as usual at the end of the lecture. They will help you to check better your comprehension of the content of the language of the lecture. And this is the list of the sources which can be used for further reading. Thank you for your attention.